Good morning, students. Here we come up with the bronchopulmonary segments. Very interesting cross anatomy lecture. The bronchopulmonary segments. In the bronchopulmonary segments, first we start with the definition, and then we will discuss the number of bronchopulmonary segments, total number on the right and left lung, that is in the right and the left lung, how many, total number, and then applied anatomy. Definition. First there is, we will go according to the diagram, we know the trachea, we know the principal bronchi, right and left bronchi, right and left bronchi. So each right and left principal bronchi will divide into, after entering the lung, as the right and the left principal bronchus, as they enter the lung, the right and the left principal bronchus, as they enter the lung, they will divide into various smaller divisions for each and every lobes present in right and left lung. In the right side there are three lobes, in the left side there are two lobes. So right lung carries three lobes and left lung carries two lobes. So therefore, right principal bronchus will divide into three secondary bronchi, or they are called lobar bronchi. So here we divide into one, this will be two, and this will be the third. So these three, what we have drawn, they are the secondary bronchi, or they are called lobar bronchi. So please note down these three segments as secondary bronchi or lobar bronchi. So this is the upper secondary lobar bronchi, this is the middle secondary lobar bronchi, and this is the inferior lower secondary lobar bronchi of the right lung. On the left side, since there are two lobes, so there will be two lobar bronchi or two secondary bronchi. So here, this is one, and this one will be second. So again, these two are the upper and lower, the upper as well as this one is the lower, upper and lower secondary bronchi, or it is called lobar bronchi. So therefore, on the right side there are three lobar bronchi or three secondary bronchi, on the left side there are two lobar bronchi or two secondary bronchi. Very simple. Now what happens? Each of these lobar bronchi will further subdivide into various segments, and they are called tertiary bronchi. And these tertiary bronchi, here for example, in the upper part, I will use different color. So with yellow color, in the upper part, there will be, let me use this green color, three tertiary bronchi, and therefore they are, for example, if I draw here, apical segment, then anterior segment, and then posterior segment. So here, I will just name it as apical, this is anterior, this is posterior segment for the right side upper lobar bronchi. Then for the right side middle lobar bronchi, there will be two segments, and those two segments will be, for example, here I will draw the two segments, and they are the right medial and right lateral. So this one will be the medial, this one will be the lateral segment. Remember, these are the subdivisions of tertiary bronchi, or they are called segmental bronchi. Similarly, for the right lower secondary bronchus or lobar bronchus will subdivide into, see the divisions, I will draw the divisions from here. So this one will be apical, medial lateral, so I will keep on writing apical, then medial basal, it is not lateral but medial basal, then there will be, here I will draw anterior, that is anterior basal, it is called anterior basal. Then I will draw here posterior basal. This is also anterior basal. So anterior basal, posterior basal, and the last one, lateral basal. Lateral basal. So altogether, if you consider 1, 2, 3 apical, anterior, posterior for the upper, for the middle 2, medial and lateral, for the lower 5, apical, anterior basal, medial basal, lateral basal, posterior basal. So altogether 5 plus 5, that means 3 plus 2 plus 5 is equal to 10 segments. These 10 segments, now here I am going to write down, these 10 segments are known as bronchopulmonary segments. So therefore, definition of bronchopulmonary segment will be, first you have to write all these points, and then you have to mention the definition of bronchopulmonary segment is an area of lung which is aerated by one segmental bronchi. And what is the segmental bronchi? This is segmental bronchi, this is segmental bronchi, this is segmental bronchi, this is segmental bronchi. That means tertiary bronchi are called segmental bronchi. Area of lung which is aerated by one tertiary bronchi or segmental bronchi is known as bronchopulmonary segment. So therefore, these bronchopulmonary segments, how many are there? On the right side there are 10, and on the left side, different books have mentioned different number, but we will stick to this way. Some books they mention 8, some books they mention 9, some books they mention 10, but it is basically true. There may be presence of one segment or there may be absence of two segments. So that will lead to, on the left lung, in the left lung there will be, there may be 8 or there may be 9 or there may be 10, we'll go across that. So therefore, each bronchopulmonary segment is nothing but the area of lung which is aerated by one segmental bronchi or one tertiary bronchi, that is bronchopulmonary segment. Now we come across to left side. In the left side, since there are two lower bronchi, now we have to subdivide them into segmental or tertiary bronchi, and these tertiary bronchi will form bronchopulmonary segment. So therefore, this we will divide into, from here there will be starting of first apical, then second anterior, and then third posterior. So therefore, here we are going to write down simply as apical, then anterior, then posterior, and two more. The remaining two will be, we start with 1 and 2. So these two will be known as superior lingular, inferior lingular, or it is also known as upper lingular, lower lingular. So superior lingular, inferior lingular. These are the 5 segmental bronchi on the left side belonging to the upper lobar bronchi, upper lobe, belonging to upper lobe, because in the left lung there are 2 lobes, upper and lower. So in the upper, apical, anterior, posterior, superior lingular, inferior lingular. Now inferior, this lower secondary bronchi, there will be, we will start with here. So this one will be, according to the right, if you compare with the right, here same, apical, then we start with this medial basal, then we go with this posterior basal, and then the remaining two, anterior basal, lateral basal. So here we come up with anterior basal, lateral basal. So anterior basal and lateral basal. This is how the bronchi will divide. So ultimately, the entire division of the bronchi, it will lead to the development of bronchopulmonary segments That is, they are aerated by tertiary or segmental bronchi. So in the left side, how many are there? 5 in the upper lobe, another 5 in the lower lobe. Now there may be presence or absence of the medial basal. Medial basal in the lower lobe of the left lung may be present or absent. And at the same time, the apical segment in the upper lobe may be fused with the posterior segment. So in those cases, the number of segments will be 8. And if the segments are independent, then the number of segments will be 10. So stick to this. We are having this very clear view. Apical, anterior, posterior, superior lingular, infralingular in the upper lobe of the left lung. And in the lower lobe, we have the apical, anterior basal, lateral basal, medial basal, posterior basal. And medial basal may sometimes be absent. So these are the bronchopulmonary segments. Now, further detail of bronchopulmonary segment. We know the definition of bronchopulmonary segment. It is the area of the lung which is aerated by the tertiary or segmental bronchi. How many are there? We have discussed. So if you come on this side, see here, total number, if you see here, the total number, 10 on right side and 10 on left side, the names you have to mention. What are the names? The names are on the right side. Once again, these names are very important. You have to mark them. On the right side, upper lobe, apical, then anterior, then posterior. Then in the right side, middle lobe will contain medial, lateral. Then right side, lower lobe will contain apical, anterior basal, medial basal, lateral basal, posterior basal. So total 10 bronchopulmonary segments. Left side, total, so here also I will write down both right and left, 10. So on the left side, there will be apical, anterior, then posterior, then superior lingular, inferior lingular for the upper lobe and lower lobe, anterior basal, medial basal, lateral basal, then posterior basal and apical. Please note down. So here we complete the total number. Now some details. Now each bronchopulmonary segment, if we come on this side, please come on this side. Each bronchopulmonary segment, you have to draw this. Each bronchopulmonary segment will be in the shape of this. Now this is how each bronchopulmonary segment will be present. It is a triangular segment. Now here we will draw the two bronchopulmonary segments. These are the two bronchopulmonary segments. Now these bronchopulmonary segments, as we have discussed, how many they are? 10 and 10. They are triangular with their bases towards the surface pleura. So the base of each triangular segment, bronchopulmonary segments, will be directed towards the surface, and apex will be directed towards the tertiary bronchi or segmental bronchi. Note this point. Each bronchopulmonary segment, now it consists of area of the lung which is aerated by tertiary or segmental bronchi, and this piece or this area of the tissue of the lung will be triangular in structure. These triangular bronchopulmonary segments, their surface, the base, will be directed towards the surface. The base of each bronchopulmonary segment is directed towards the surface and apex is towards the tertiary bronchus. So therefore, in between there will be intersegmental areolar septa. So in between there is intersegmental areolar septa, which we can show with this color. So it will contain intersegmental areolar septa. That is in between the bronchopulmonary segment. Now here also there will be intersegmental areolar septa. On this side also I will draw intersegmental areolar septa. Very clear. Now we show that within the bronchopulmonary segment, here I will just mention bronchopulmonary segment. Bronchopulmonary segment. Within the bronchopulmonary segment, there will be tertiary bronchi which is coming from above, and that tertiary bronchi, I am going to show here. This is the tertiary bronchus which is coming from above. So each bronchopulmonary segment will contain what structure? Tertiary bronchus. Now here also I will draw this tertiary bronchus. So it is very clear now. Tertiary bronchus which is coming within the bronchopulmonary segment. Along with tertiary bronchus, it will contain one very important structure, and that will be pulmonary artery. And pulmonary artery you always draw with blue color because it will carry impure blood. So here I will show pulmonary artery. This is the pulmonary artery. So this is the pulmonary artery. So here you show this pulmonary artery with blue color, and we are going to mention here first, this is the tertiary bronchus, or it is called segmental bronchus. And second, we are going to write here pulmonary artery. So each bronchopulmonary segment, triangular structure with its base directed towards the surface, apex is directed towards the tertiary bronchus, that is segmental bronchus, will contain two structures. What are those two structures? Tertiary bronchus and the pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery should be drawn with blue color because it contains impure blood. Now there is intersegmental alveolar septa. So that is what you need to mention. Now this is the intersegmental alveolar septa. This intersegmental alveolar septa will contain one structure which is very important, that is pulmonary vein. And pulmonary vein you draw with red color because it carries pure blood. So here we draw pulmonary vein. This is where we draw the pulmonary vein. Here also intersegmental structure, we draw here the pulmonary vein. And here also in the intersegmental areolar tissue, we draw the pulmonary vein. And blood will be carried through the pulmonary artery here in this direction, and then from the pulmonary artery it will be directed towards the pulmonary vein in this way. It will be directed towards the pulmonary vein, and therefore the blood will be carried in the pulmonary vein in this direction. It will be carried in pulmonary vein in this direction. So here lots of MCQs are there, so many times frequently asked, and one more question answer. Note down, pulmonary, each bronchopulmonary segment will contain two structures, tertiary bronchus and pulmonary artery. So therefore pulmonary artery is segmental structure. Note down, this is an important part. Pulmonary artery is segmental. Pulmonary vein is intersegmental. So pulmonary vein is intersegmental structure. These are many times asked in MCQs, or one mark question answer. Always remember it throughout your life that pulmonary artery will be segmental structure and pulmonary vein is intersegmental structure. So pulmonary vein will drain more than one bronchopulmonary segments. It will drain bronchopulmonary segments on either side, more than one bronchopulmonary segments. Remember that, because it is intersegmental structure. Now, applied anatomy. In the applied anatomy, first point, what we need to understand will be, please come on this side, I think so, we'll come on this side. In the applied anatomy, the first point will be interalveolar segmental septa are present. So they will serve as a barrier for the spreading of infection. So it will not allow any infection to spread in between the bronchopulmonary segments because they are separated by interareolar segmental septa. There will be the connective tissue septa, intersegmental areolar septa, which is separating each and every bronchopulmonary segments. So the bronchopulmonary segments will be having these septa and they will prevent the spreading of infection. So they will function as barrier. But in cases of cancer as well as tuberculosis, the barrier may be penetrated. So in cases of cancer and tuberculosis, these kind of infections, cancer and tuberculosis may spread, it can spread, it can cross the barrier, it can cross the bronchopulmonary segments from one segment to another. So therefore, these intersegmental areolar septa will function as a barrier only to certain infections, but it may not function as a barrier for cancer spread and tuberculosis. Constraint of time coming up in the next segment. So therefore, now this is the first point. So therefore, if you draw the bronchopulmonary segments, if you show the bronchopulmonary segments, they will be in this way. Here I am going to show with blue color not blue color, but I can show with orange color. So if you show these bronchopulmonary segments, they are like this. These are the bronchopulmonary segments. So these are the bronchopulmonary segments. And these bronchopulmonary segments here, which we show, this gives us the fair idea that these bronchopulmonary segments are triangular with their bases directed towards the surface and apex towards the tertiary bronchus. And one of these bronchopulmonary segments we have drawn there, two bronchopulmonary segments which we have shown there. So in the applied anatomy, in between bronchopulmonary segments, there are inter-areolar segmental septa, connective tissue septa, which will function as the barrier to the spread of infection, except cancer and TB, cancer and tuberculosis. Now second, now in the second applied anatomy, which is very interesting, this is many times asked in MCQs, one more question answer. What is there? The apical lobe of lower, the apical segment, I will write down the apical segment of lower lobe. Now remember, apical segment has or is present in both the right and left lungs, in the lower lobes of both right and left lungs. Apical segment here and apical segment here of the lower lobes of the right and left lungs, as well as along with this apical segment of the lower lobes of right and left lungs, along with that posterior segment of upper lobe. And if you recollect here, this is the posterior segment of upper lobe on the right side, and this one will be the posterior segment of the upper lobe of the left side, both. So posterior segment of upper lobe and apical segment of lower lobe, right and left, these are the most vulnerable portions in case of lung abscess, because aspiration may take place, the infections, the infected materials can be aspirated in these segments. So they are the most vulnerable in case of lung abscess. And why they are most vulnerable in case of lung abscess? Because these two segments in supine position, they are the most predominant segments in which the infected material can be aspirated directly into these two segments. So therefore, always note down, this is asked in MCQs, one more question answer. Which two segments? Apical segment of the lower lobe and the posterior segment of upper lobe. Apical segment of lower lobe and posterior segment of upper lobe. Apical segment of lower lobe and posterior segment of upper lobe. Lung abscess, they are the most predominant segments for any infections to be aspirated. So lung abscess commonly occurs here. And the third point, now comes the third point. In the third point, the same. But you need one segment. Apical segment of lower lobe. Now you consider this. Apical segment of lower lobe is where aspiration pneumonia takes place. So aspiration pneumonia will be affecting apical segment of lower lobe. And this syndrome, where aspiration pneumonia occurs in apical segment of lower lobe, is known as Mendelssohn's syndrome. So just write down the name, Mendelssohn's syndrome. This is asked in one mark question answer. One mark question answer. Mendelssohn's syndrome. What is Mendelssohn's syndrome? It is nothing but aspiration pneumonia which occurs in the apical segment of the lower lobe. So 3 points we have finished of the applied anatomy. Please note down. All these 3 points are very important. Now once again, bronchopulmonary segments which we have written, you need to write down in the middle only, where we have discussed how many bronchopulmonary segments are there on the right side, 10, and how many on the left side, 10. All the names you have to mention, all these names which whatever we have discussed, you need to write down. These are the names of bronchopulmonary segments, but that should be in the middle of the topic when we had discussed at that time. So here we have discussed in a very simple way, very interesting way and simplistic way, the entire bronchopulmonary segments. Thank you very much.